From this point onward, we will consider linear programs in their standard form, where the constraints are expressed as equalities. We will have an underdetermined system of equations that has lots of solutions, and we'll try to find the one that maximizes the objective function. Now, if you've ever had to come up with a solution to an underdetermined system on your own, you'll have noticed that it's easiest to find one by simply setting some of the coefficients to zero so as to create a square system, and then solving for the rest of the coefficients. In effect, this is what solvers like MATLAB do as well. These solutions are called basic solutions, and it turns out that to solve linear programs, basic solutions are the only ones that we will need to consider. The trick, however, is figuring out which coefficients need to be set to zero. With that intuition in mind, let's dive into the details.
Switching over now entirely to considering linear programs in standard form, I want to define some vocabulary that will be useful going forward. First, we say that a vector x is a solution if and only if ax is equal to b. A basic solution is one generated as follows. We'll pick an increasing sequence of m column numbers so that the corresponding columns are linearly independent, and we'll call the resulting matrix B. This is easiest to see when the chosen columns are the first m, and we'll use this convention for most of our treatment. We define xb to be b inverse times this b here, and then embed this in a longer vector x, putting the value from xb for columns in the sequence and zero otherwise. This x is a basic solution. Really, all that we're trying to accomplish here is to let xb get multiplied with the columns of b and zero to get multiplied with the columns of d. Remember that post-multiplication corresponds to column operations. So that then is a basic solution, and we call it basic because it came from our choice of this linearly independent set of columns, which forms a basis for the column space. From this basis, we get a basic solution. It is possible for more than one basis to yield the same basic solution if some of the entries of this xb are zero. Such a solution is called degenerate. This corresponds to the case where a vertex is at the intersection of more than n hyperplanes in the symmetric form. So far, this vocabulary only addresses the equality constraints. Adding in the non-negativity constraints in the variables, we use the word feasible. Thus, a feasible solution is a solution that has all non-negative entries. And a basic feasible solution is one that comes from a basis, as described above, and has all non-negative entries.